Hi, this is Dr. B. Let's do the SO4 2- Lewis structure for the sulfate ion. On the periodic table, sulfur 6 valence electrons. Oxygen also has 6. We have 4 oxygens multiplied by 4, and these 2 valence electrons up here, we need to add those as well. That gives us a total of 32 valence electrons. We'll put the sulfur in the center, and then the 4 oxygens will go on the outside. Next, we'll draw bonds between the sulfur and the oxygens. So there we have 4 bonds and we've used 8 valence electrons. Let's go around the outer atoms and make sure they have octets. So we've used 8, 10, 12, and 32. Looking at the structure here, we see that each of the oxygens has 8 valence electrons, 2, 4, 6, 8, as does the sulfur here. 2, 4, 6, 8. But we're not quite done yet. Sulfur is in the third period of the periodic table. That means it can hold more than 8 valence electrons, so we really do need to check our formal charges. So to calculate the formal charge on the sulfur, we see that sulfur on the periodic table, group 16 or 6, has 6 valence electrons. Up here, all of the electrons, all of them are involved in bonds, so that's going to be 0. And the bonding electrons, 2, 4, 6, 8. We've used 8 of those, and we'll divide that by 2. 6 minus 0 minus 4 gives us a plus 2 formal charge for the sulfur. For the oxygen, it's also in group 6 or 16, so it has 6 valence electrons. Up here, non-bonding, we have 6, and then bonding, we have 2. And all these oxygens are the same, so we only need to do 1. So 6 minus 6 minus 2 gives us a minus 1 formal charge for each oxygen. If we add up all the formal charges, the minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and plus 2, we do get a total charge of negative 2. That does make sense, but with formal charges, we want them to be as close to 0 as possible for the atoms. So let's see if we might be able to do another Lewis structure that has more zeros for the formal charges. When I see this plus 2 charge here on the sulfur, I know that I can move electrons from the outer valence electrons of the oxygen into the middle. So if I do that twice, if I move these two into the middle to form double bonds and get rid of them, I think that'll get rid of the positive 2 charge. So let's try that and then recalculate our formal charges. So I've moved electrons from the outside of these two green oxygens into the middle to form double bond. Let's see how that changes the formal charges. So for sulfur, 6 minus 0, there are no non-bonding, and now we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 total bonding electrons. 6 minus 6, that gives us 0. So the formal charge on the sulfur is 0. If we look at the green oxygens, you can see we have 6 minus 4 of the non-bonding, and then 4 bonding. We divide by 2. 6 minus 4 minus 2 is 0. Finally, looking at the blue oxygens, we have 6 minus 6 non-bonding, and then 2 bonding, divided by 2. 6 minus 6 minus 1 is minus 1. So at this point, we see that we have mostly zeros, but if you look, you have a negative 1 and a negative 1 here. That works well with this. And since more of the formal charges are zero, this is a better structure for SO42-. Since it's an ion, there's one last thing we need to do. We need to put brackets around it to show that it's an ion in the charge of the ion. And we add our 2- right there. And that is the Lewis structure for SO42-. It was a bit of work, but we have the best structure here. Our formal charges are in good shape. We've used all the valence electrons. So that's it. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.